What is going on, everybody? This is Peaker Goose here, coming at you guys today with a different type of video. First, let me say, I know it's been a while. I want to thank everybody, whether you do YouTube videos or not, and I consider you my friends or respect you, or even I don't really talk to you that much. I appreciate it for all the hate where you've been. And the same thing goes for my subscribers that have done that as well. A question I get asked all the time about vinyl. People want to learn about vinyl. I'm going to show you guys things I've added to my collection recently. Some of these may or may not be worth money. So this is a vinyl haul. This is Metallica Creeping Death. I did buy all that vinyl haul off of Dick Burns. I'm not going to say how much I paid for it. I've never had vinyl packed as securely as he did, so I have to give a shout out and a thank you to him. This is Metallica Creeping Death, and one question I always get about vinyls is, hey, are they all LPs? And the answer is no. The LP of this would have been Ride the Lightning, which would have been, you know, the long play. That's what LP really means. As you can see, if you turn on the back, side one only has Creeping Death, and side two only has Am I Evil and Blitzkrieg, which are two covers. I think they're both by Diamond Head. I know that Am I Evil is. So this is really cool. This is the import from France. This is called an EP. This is, and that stands for an extended play. And that's something kind of in the middle. Okay, and this is Slayer Haunting the Chapel. And I'm just going to show you guys my metal at first. And then after that, we're going to go into more of the other types of things I listen to. Because I like all different types of music. This is one of the craziest things I've ever heard. When I first heard Haunting the Chapel, it converted me to a full-fledged metalhead. I mean, I'm going to be straight up with you guys. And so this is an EP that stands for Extended Play. And if we look on the back, it has Chemical Warfare, Captor of Sin, Haunting the Chapel itself, and Aggressive Perfector, which is a Judas Priest cover. For all you vinyl collectors out there, you're thinking, come on, you already know this. But, you know, this is really aimed towards my subscribers who are more just into buying and selling things. This is called a picture disc, and it's supposed to look this way, okay? You know, so you want to make sure you say that in the ad. So this is the re-release of 2008. This is not the original Haunting the Chapel, but this is still worth some money. And if I were going to resell it, I would still make a decent profit. Next, this is a new one I bought, Black Sabbath 13. This came out a few months ago. Kind of a return album. It's their first album with Ozzy since 1978. Gatefold. If you ever have something that opens up like this, it's called a gatefold. And a lot of records have this. It doesn't necessarily mean it's more valuable. Some records have like a gatefold edition and a regular edition. Great, great, great record. You probably won't find this to resell just yet. We got Dio, Last in Line. I got this for $1 at a thrift store. It's a copy of Killers, Iron Maiden. I got this at a record store for $5. Actually got both of these at a record store for $5. Mint, okay. This is a first edition. So is this. I mean, just awesome. I mean, obviously, I already had these in my collection, but I mean, I had to upgrade and sell the others. Next, I found King Diamond Them. This is my favorite King Diamond album. I really love concept records, and that's why I think I like King Diamond so much. The artwork on the cover is really good. There's a very clean copy. You know, I'm all about picking up the clean copies. Metallica's Load. I got this because find the Load on LP is a little bit more rare. This is a gatefold, like I said before. A little bit trickier to come into. Yes, I actually do like the Load and Reload albums. I mean, they're not thrash, but they're not supposed to be. I can go on a big long rant about how these blow away the Black Album, but I won't. Next, we got the two re-releases of Pantera. We got, you know, these are also both gatefolds, Cowboys from Hell, awesome, awesome album. And one of the albums that inspired me to play guitar, we got a Vulgar Display of Power, or just Vulgar Display of Power. And these feature the late great guitarist Dimebag Darrell on there, of course. Awesome player. I think that he's either very overrated or very underrated, depending on who you talk to. I think lately he's about rated about where he deserves to be, because let's face it, in the 2000s, he was the only person with the, you know what, to actually play solos, as far as really big mainstream bands go. Now we're going to get away from metal a little bit and go into some of my other finds. New Oyster Cult. I love the BOC. They're just so awesome, and if no one's ever really checked out the BOC before, you gotta do so. Very clean copy here. Little bit of ring wear up here. Not that bad. Not a big deal. Things like that, I don't really mind too much. Deep Purple, made in Japan. I know it has a $6 sticker right there, but that's just an old sticker, and I paid $1 for this. Really awesome. I mean, this is probably my favorite live album ever. And inside, just beautiful, beautiful copy. I mean, like I said, there is some ring wear, but for some reason, Made in Japan always has ring wear and stuff like that. And when I said beautiful copy, I was really talking about the actual records itself. So I could probably take the records out of this, put it in my cover and everything else that's in, VG++ condition, borderline near mint. So, and I'll probably just, pick the best, keep those for me, and take the two ones that are not as good and sell those. We got this. I got this from the Cripple Picker. I can't believe I never showed this. I got this months ago, but for some reason, I don't think I ever gave him a shout out, and I told him I would, because he deserved one. This is Heart, the self-titled Heart. Very clean copy here. Sounds great. I love the spin. Next, Dollar Queen, The Game. Queen is one of the first two bands that got me into loving music. Very clean copy, like I said. Not a very expensive album, but I mean, for some reason I didn't have The Game on vinyl, so I had to pick it up. The other band that really got me into music, by the way, being Van Halen. Van Halen and Queen are all I listened to. I was probably like 11 years old. Steve Vai. This is Passion and Warfare. One of the best guitarists in the world. I'll say that. I mean, whether you like his style or not, he's very eccentric and very original. That's what I like about him. I mean, when you listen to Steve Vai's song, you know Steve Vai within about 3.5 seconds. Instantly know. Very clean copy. Eagles Live. I'm a big Eagles fan. And I didn't have this one in my collection. So, another gatefold, I decided to add it. Awesome. I mean, the list on here is amazing. I mean, Hotel California, Heartache Tonight, I Can't Tell You Why, The Long Run, New Kid in Town, Life's Been Good, Seven Bridges Road, Wasted Time, Take It to the Limit. I mean, and it goes on and on and on. Desperado, Life in a Fast Lane, Take It Easy. I mean, these guys just pump out the hits. It's insane. It's insane. Speaking of the Eagles, also got The Long Run. Very clean copy of this. I would say this is VG++. Then we got Rolling Stones. Valor. I mean, can't pass up on the Stones for a buck. Same thing with Sir Paul McCartney. But can't pass them up. Please comment. Again, this is a little cut out here. I already have this in my collection. The actual vinyl is a little bit better, so we're going to do the swap-a-rooney. Swap-a-rooney, where I get these things from. Here's a Wings. I don't have this one yet. It's not, I mean, look at this thing. It's kind of putting it on the bottom. Believe it or not, the record's actually pretty good, but I mean, this cover's taking a beating, but you know, I don't have it yet. Crocus the Blitz. I got this just to resell. I already had this one, and this one is in worse condition than mine. So, I'm gonna sell it. This is actually also metal. I just forgot to put it in the earlier one. And lastly, we got this to resell. It's a laser disc. Viva Las Vegas, Elvis Presley. And what a laser disc is. I can't play these or anything, but I mean, there is not a mark on this at all. And, unlike vinyls, you can't really wear these out because it's not a physical method. And with that said, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you very much, and have a good one out there. All right, I hope you guys make some money. Pick it.